Party going up. A champ with the crown is here. I'm a winning player. Hey, so shake it like you don't care. I shake it up everywhere. And I can bake cakes by the pound. Blow the whistle cause I love that sound. And we can just keep going round. I'm ready for another round.
The scene a short time ago, this crowd, they love their 49ers, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. And we're ready for football as the 49ers get set to do battle with the Baltimore Ravens. It's a rematch of Super Bowl 47 minus one Harbaugh. The Ravens and 49ers are underway. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
At their own 34-yard line.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. First carry for the former Buckeye, J.K. Dobbins. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now.
Play. Second and 10 at the 34-yard line.
From the gun, it's Jackson. Oh, a scram for the football, and he's going to come down with it. That one good for 26 and a first down.
26 yards.
Nice job there of utilizing. His big target, and he didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10, right at the 40. A shotgun snap and a give to Dobbins. And a pretty good run there as he gets 7 down to the 33.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easy.
Dobbins hit, and he fumbles. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at the 33-yard line. They'll run for the first time with Raheem Mostert. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line.
Jordan Richards,
the one there to bring him down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Working from the gun, Garoppolo. And that will be incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down. And with the play clock about to expire, Kyle Shanahan's going to use a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Big decision here early. Look at this. They're going to go for it on their own side of the field. They do go for it. It's Garoppolo. Blitz coming and down he goes. Patrick Queen. And that will force a turnover on downs. So shall we say a bold decision to go for it. And that bold decision does not pay off.
And when you talk about bold, you're saying all caps?
All caps.
Yeah, without a doubt. Maybe they're telling their defense they have a lot of faith in them. I mean, that's how you have to spin it, is that you tell your defense, you know something? We were able to go for it there because you guys are so good. I'm not worried about things. That's the only explanation I can come up with in this situation.
He better get ready to spin it for that post-game presser because you know he's going to be out.
He's going to have to spin it for his own locker room, frankly.
The full start backs him up five, first and 15. Dobbins running out of the gun. They get 14 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty.
That was huge after being behind the chains on first down to make this second very manageable.
Yeah, how much pride do you have in an offense on first down to get that kind of yardage? Because it actually opens up your playbook on second down. You can run it, you can throw it, you keep a defense off balance. I like that phrase, stand ahead of the chains, and they're doing exactly that.
7 yards there and a first down.
A gain of seven. First down, Raven.
Jackson from the shotgun. That's complete right around the eight. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown.
Touchdown, Baltimore.
A 16-yard touchdown. And the Ravens have taken the early lead. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
They're on the 24-yard line.
The
San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Well, we'll see what his offense can do. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Throwing now is Garoppolo. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Chuck Clark just would not be denied. That's a loss of seven. Well, it was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Well, that last sack, it puts Garoppolo and the 49ers in a tough spot. They face a third and long. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. Open man is Taylor. He's got it. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Trent Taylor, 84 yards. And the Niners, if they can convert the extra point, they'll grab the lead. And Charles, I had an offensive coordinator tell me one time that they designed every play to score. I don't know how true that is, but he had to run a long way after that catch. Heck of a play.
I think that when he was telling you that, he was designing run after catch in every block. I mean, that's the only way to put it in there, and that's what we got on that one. Nice catch, an even better run for big yardage.
San Francisco.
So back even at six apiece as the kick's away. And a short kick taking it about the 16. A lane opens here. He's past the 30.
Over first and 10 at their own 32-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They'll start on the ground with Dobbins. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. From the gun, Jackson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first rounder, Jimmy Ward. And he will be brought down, but he's got the interception on the final play of this first quarter. These two teams all tied after one. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. So after the INT, it's Garoppolo. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. Touchdown, 49ers! Jimmy Garoppolo with his second touchdown pass in his first half. And the 49ers have now taken the lead.
For a big tight end, he can sure move like a slot receiver when he gets a head of steam going. And as a defensive back, you've got a big decision to make when he's moving like that.
And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead.
Niners 13, Ravens 6. Mitch Wishnowski to kick off for San Francisco.
Thank you. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. Fields it in the middle of the end zone, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
25-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. A touchdown would tie it. They trail 13-6 as they come up with a first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Yeah, quick throw here. That's complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
Second and two at the 33-yard line.
To throw again on second down. Jackson, open man is the tight end, Nick Boyle. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
It's a gain of.
That was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Jackson on the give to Dobbins. He'll get about four here. Down to the 43-yard line.
Dobbins on the
well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. From the gun, Jackson. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 7 yards there and a first down.
Ravens.
Operating from the gun, Jackson, over the middle here to Brown,
Jackson,
and all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Baltimore,
dancing to his left, and he's going to keep it here. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of nine on first down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Remaining in this first half of football. Time rolls around. Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play. Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. Lamar Jackson hooking up with Mark Andrews, and the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury, and it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run, and he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
13, Ravens 12. Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. taken in the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
First and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments. And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Garoppolo. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Trying to defend the out route there, got the PI call.
And you know what's difficult about that one? Is sometimes you want to make the undercut move and go for the football, and other times just want to hang on the upfield shoulder and make the tackle. I think he got caught in between and created a foul.
Now left side on the swing pass. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains. Again, they'll throw with Garoppolo. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Given back-to-back catches now. That one for 16. And another first down.
At the 36-yard line.
Garoppolo again. And this will be incomplete. Garoppolo. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. And yet again, it's Garoppolo. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 20-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Here to Bourne, and the Niners are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds. Left in the second quarter.
First and goal at the 4-yard line.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Garoppolo, a final shot here before half. And he hauls it in the end zone. Touchdown, San Francisco. Debo Samuel on the touchdown pass from Jimmy Garoppolo. And the 49ers add on to their lead. Now Gold for the extra point. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go.
The score, Niners 20, Ravens 12. Mitch Wishnowski to kick off for San Francisco.
So with 3 seconds remaining in the half, they will line up to kick this one away. A fairly short kick from the 14. A dangerous return man showing it here. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Okay, coach. Appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the second half. And we see James, he will not return it, and they'll bring it out to the 25. San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now, they're just cutting them to shreds.
That incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Garoppolo now. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Have to give some credit to the defender on that when he read all the keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. All going deep here for Taylor. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get him to fourth down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. That took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Wishnowski on to punt as he sends this one away. And now a fair catch called for and taken just outside the 40-yard line. Officially, that'll be marked down as just a 28-yard punt. And the Ravens, they'll take over. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Their defense just came up with a stop right out of the locker room, and now can the offense take advantage?
Yeah, we don't want to turn this into something that it's not. It's only a one-score game, so it's not exactly a crucial possession. But at the same time, they'd like to get things started and at least come away with 3 points.
First down.
Jackson on first down. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Another attempt, another incompletion. And when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long game or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points. And the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones in the.
And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore. Hollywood, Marquise Brown, 40 yards. And now the Ravens, they're just a 2-point conversion away from tying this up.
the Ravens.
John Harbaugh thought about it, and now his guys are going to go for the two-point conversion. And Jackson throwing once more. Throws right side. And he's got it. So they went ahead and went for two to tie the game, and it works out.
Justin Tucker to kick off.
So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. Fielded in the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
First down team at their own 20-yard line.
Set to get this drive underway, and their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back, and he stops right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Here's a second and 5 now from the 25. Garoppolo going to give the motion. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Brings up third and 4.
Garoppolo looks to throw. Got his target, Samuel. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Garoppolo able to find Samuel there for a Niners first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
A carry there for Mostert as he's able to work his way forward for a pretty good pickup on first down. Officially a gain of 5.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up second and 5. At the 42-yard line.
Once again, it's Mostert. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and 6. Garoppolo into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith, and they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
At their own 49-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and 6.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. They'll go again with Dobbins. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on third down?
Well, every now and then we have to let a cliche fly, partner. And in this case, what do they say in the NFL? Your gustability is often your availability. This is an extremely durable kid coming out of Ohio State. Carried the ball every time they even thought about running it. Wore down defenses and able to break big runs late in games. J.K. Dobbins going to Baltimore, an absolute perfect fit.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. From the gun, it's Jackson. Brought in left side by Sneed. Complete. A gain of 6 there on first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Now it's Jackson. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 9 yards the pickup there, and it's a first down.
First down, Ravens.
They'll run. It's Dobbins. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. There to stop him on the defensive side, Fred Warner.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Jackson's throw on target to Willie Snead. That catch good for five. It's third down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
First and goal, Baltimore.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They've got it first and goal, looking to take the lead here in the late going. And the Ravens are going to be set up with a first and goal. He couldn't quite reach the chalk, but they'll have it at the 1 yard line. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal. Try to run with Dobbins, and he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Taking it in from a yard out, and the Ravens have broken the tie.
And that score deserves our respect, deserves our excitement. But I'm looking at the clock, and I'm thinking, there's a long way to go in this one.
Ideally, they would have liked to milk a little bit more time off. Now on the other sideline, you start to get the crew together and say, this is what we practiced the two-minute drill for, right?
Yeah, you hope you've been in that situation before, and if you haven't, you just have the confidence, hey, let's go down there and get this thing done. But boy, that's a big score right there to give them the advantage.
Takes this about 5 yards deep. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
Take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. They're down here in a one-score game. At the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late-game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Garoppolo to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's caught. It's a touchdown. So they rally here in the final minute. And they're an extra point away from tying this game.
The receivers have been running them ragged, maybe some tired legs in the secondary, maybe some tired legs in the pass rush. Didn't get to it, and look what resulted. A touchdown, tie game. They've got a chance to take the lead.
And now the decision is to go for two. A gutsy call, and this, in effect, is your ball game right here. And they do not get it. It's incomplete. They went for the win, and the big gamble does not pay off.
49ers 26.
So still a chance with just over 20 seconds to go, but they need to get this one back, no doubt. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And who's got it? I think the Ravens do. Yes. And they're going to win this football game. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
So the final seconds tick away in this Baltimore victory. And I tell you, this was a fun one, just a close game. Nothing comes easy in this league, as you know. They had to work for that victory.
I've got to go back to what you just said. Nothing comes easy in this league. How many times have we talked to coaches prior to a game and assessed, you know, the strengths, the weaknesses, the whole deal? Even in games when one coach was a decided favorite, what do they always say to us? But you do know, this is really a 7-point league. 7 points either way usually decides a ball game. We had exactly that in this one.
And not only that, but this is a gutsy road victory, one they can hang their hat on. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we say so long from Santa Clara.
For the wins, came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business, whole team got wins in the world suspended. I told them what I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was popped, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in, I've been on 10-10 since. Who really holding it down, I've been holding it down and I go it again and again. Who is the dummy that died, I'm the coldest of remedy, falling again and again. I'm in the butt, I'm in the...